Yes, my people, good day. Customer states, van is running, I'm in a transit.
Bam!
Poor transit to the rescue. Van running hot, and this is the second time I replaced some hoses. It keeps busting hoses, upper hose, lower hose, heater core hose. So we're chasing a hose problem. Initially, I was suspecting that it had a blown head gasket, but not absolutely sure. So I'm doing some diagnosis. Let me show you how we do it. Let's go. First step. No matter how long I ran it, it never passed the middle. When you have a blown head gasket, it usually keeps creeping up, getting kind of hot, but it always stays in the middle, and I hear the fans running. But the fans running, that's deceptive too. Let me show you. Notice the temperature. 224 cylinder head temperature, right? Fan on. High speed and low speed. On. And you can hear both of them. Not sure if you're going to be able to see them, but that one running, and that one running. Both of them running, high speed. Okay, so thought process. The temperature gauge not moving from the middle, stays right there. It's running a little warm according to my readings right there. I should be in the 190s, and both fans coming on. So if both fans coming on, it tells me that both fans are working, and also tell me that relays that control the fans are working. It also tells me that no fuses are blown because the fans are working. So next step now is to check the wiring diagram and see how the circuit worked. Simple enough, what could be going on? How we're running hot and the fans are running. Let's go, watch this. All right, wiring diagram time. Okay, this is the cooling fan circuit. All these things here, let the fans work. Let me identify what we're looking at. Power train control module, that's it. You see two signals coming out. All right, you have a cooling fan motor, that's one. And then we have a cooling fan motor, that's two. We already determined that there are two fans behind the radiator. So now in here, what you're looking at, this grayed out area, I don't want to move too fast. This grayed out area, this is a battery junction box, right? So these components are in the battery junction box. You have fan control relay one, which is, you see that FC1. And then there's FC2, fan control relay 2. I would suppose that is speed 1, slow and fast, right? And then we have here a third relay, which is a little bit confusing, FC3. So Ford has three relays to control two fans. Up top, we have the fuses. We have fuse 30, which is a 40 amp. We have fuse 29, which is a 10 amp. We have fuse 31, which is a 40 amp. In the battery junction box. So that's battery junction box, and that is battery junction box. So all of these things are contained in here. So now, where are the battery junction box? Next paper. You look it up with your diagnostics, and this is your battery junction box. That is what it looks like, see? And then at the lower part, there's a key, and I circled it. Fan control 2 is R5, you see that? And then I'm looking on here, and R5, high speed, it's right there. And then I circle the next one. R15 is fan control 1. And there is R15, fan control 1. So we know that we are here and here. Okay? So now, FC3 is R18, right there. And R18 is here. So we know our three locations. Right there, and right here. So now, how is this oriented in the vehicle? Now, let me show you. This is the battery junction box. Hood open, pop this bad boy open, boom. Put your purse up. Oh yeah, it's been raining. You see that? Yeah, side note. Kinda looks like this, but how we orient it? If you look at the picture, you see that you have these lugs over here. These are usually for power, right? And if you look at this, you see that there are lugs over here. See, look, there's a lug, power lug. So you orient it like so. So this is how you know. So you know it sits like this in the car. So it sits like this on your paper. So according to the diagram, this one here is, let's count. We got 1, 2. So we're at the edge here, 1. So we're dealing with this one. That is for the high speed. And then for the low speed, it's all the way at the edge over there, which is all the way at the edge right there. See, I got a little red dot on it. And then the last one, R18, right there at the end, it's in the corner. We have this one, that one, and that guy. Those three is what we're working with, right? So we are oriented. So back to our diagram. So on our diagram now, we know where our fuses are located. So one of the quick, easy steps that we can do is we can switch relays to see if that works. And sometimes you can switch a relay and find out, because usually a relay might go bad or a fuse might blow. But we know that the fuse didn't blow because the fans are working. It's working on high speed. So let's switch a relay. We're going to switch with this one. That one. Because they're the same. Boom. We'll start it back up now and see what happens. All right. Engine is back on. It's running. And I noticed something on the scanner. You see that right there? It says on. It says fan control low, which would be speed one, is on. Let's take a look because I don't hear anything. That fan is not on. That fan is off. Huh. That's peculiar. Fan one is on right now, according to the computer, and it is on. I swap relays. And that didn't fix the problem. We know that it's not fuses because both fans work in high speed, but right now it's not commanding high to come on. Let's look at this wiring diagram again. All right, good old Ford doesn't make things easy on nothing. Let me just give you a little information. With any component, there needs to be a power and a ground. Whether it be a light bulb or a fan, motor, or whatever the case may be, you have to have a power and a ground. So when you look at this fan right here, you see it has two entries. There's a power and a ground. So you have this one going up and you trace it. And you see that when this relay, this is a relay. When the relay closes, it goes directly to fuse 30, which is a 40 amp. The fan works because we saw both of them running. So we know that fuse is not cut. So, okay, we're good there. But it's not coming on low speed. Why is that? Let's look at fan number two. Before we get to that fan number two, let's look at the ground. So where does it go to ground? Let's follow that. Follow. It comes here. This is a ground right here. But no, they didn't go straight to ground. They come here. And they come here and they go back through this relay. And that relay is FC3. See that? A relay has to close to bring it to ground. And then that ground travels through. When this gets closed, all the way back down through, across, over, and goes to the cooling fan motor. Thank you, Ford, for that. But let's look at fan control 2. Power. Power, we get this relay and we go directly to F31, which is a 40 amp. When this relay closes, we get our power there, and then the ground, oh look, it goes straight to ground. It doesn't go anywhere to pass through anybody, it goes straight to ground. But fan control number one has to pass through this relay to be able to get back to ground. So now, on high speed, when the fan goes on high speed, which is this command, commands it for high. That comes up, commands it for high, that commands it for low. So when it comes up, commands it for high, it puts a ground here, and this ground grounds this relay. Fan FC2 grounds this relay, and on the other side of that relay there is power. So power and ground will cause it to work, which will close this contact here. And then this contact allows power to travel from fuse F31 through the relay down to fan control 2, put power on this side, and ground on this side is here. This motor runs. And then while it's running, both of them are running. So I'm wondering, why is it that both of them run on high speed and not on low speed? And the reason for that is this. You see this route here that Ford used, and it comes up and I have to go through this relay? Notice this branch. See that little fuse there? Goes up and out, comes around, passes through the same relay to get a ground. So this ground signal to control fan number one has to travel all the way through this fan. So if this fan is unplugged by any chance, you will never get a low speed. But if it's plugged in, it passes through the ground. Ground goes through the relay, comes back over, down, through this fuse, down, back over, through here, all the way across, and gives it a ground. And that's how you get low speed ground. Imagine that. So let's look at these fuses. It's supposed to be fuse number F8, 20 amp. Let's get the paperwork, which is, where is it? Where is it? F8 20 amp, and we know that we have it sitting like so, right? So here we go. F8 is all the way up there. We're looking right there, that blue one right there. Now check it out. Now Ford is using these fuses now. They're behind glass. You can't check these fuses. They're behind this little glass window. And most of the time when you're trying to pry it off, it breaks. And then when you look in there, through there, they don't look burned. It's not like these fuses here. You can check them. You see that little piece sticking up? You can test these fuses real easy. Not so much with these ones, right? So this is a fuse in question, the blue one. Look at it. Does it look blown to you? Especially when it's behind glass. I took the glass off. Does it look blown to you? You can't really tell. And how you need to check it is you have to pry these out. And notice they are flush. Flush with here. Flush. They must have some new tool or something. All right, let's look to see what tool they gave us. Oh, that don't pull that out. See that? Flush. So you have to pick these up with your little tool and whatever case may be. But long story short, look. I got this one out already. Do you see anything? Does anything look blown in there? Can't really, huh? On closer observation, it is blown over on that side. So it's a blown fuse. The ground has to travel through this little fuse here, which is right there, to come through the relay all the way back down to get back to this fan. So what I did was I don't have one of these on hand right now, but I have one of these. It's a little bit bigger just for test purposes. And let's see what happened. Just started it back up. Notice what it's saying. Fan control low speed on. And the fan is not on. Is not on. Fan is off. Not spinning. So now I'm going to use my test fuse. I'm going to put it in. And you might be able to hear it. Look now. See? Fan is working. Long story short, the reason it was popping hoses is, for one, the hoses are kind of old, and two, it's running hotter than normal for an extended period, and it pressures the hoses or puts the hoses under stress unduly, and they break. So the low speed was not working, only the high speed, and the high speed kicks in when the vehicle is hotter than the manufacturer wants it to be running. So once we repair the low speed operation, it should fix all the problems. You understand? So that was the thing. Thanks for staying with me on this thing, man. See the thing fixed now and everything. Have a wonderful day. See you. Bless.
And don't forget to go and subscribe to my YouTube channel.